It's finally time to play around with our data. I've got a local CSV file with all of my data, and I need to make sure that that gets up into the cloud. Additionally, I need to prepare my data. I know that what I want to do is predict how many bikes will be rented on a certain day, which means I need to prepare my data for a time series forecast. As always, there is additional documentation on the screen and in the description down below. Let's get started. First, I need to make sure my dataset is accessible. I'm going to add it to the same folder that my Jupyter notebook is in. And I'm going to upload this dataset to my machine learning data store up on Azure. I'll grab my CSV file, upload it to the dataset folder, overwrite any data that exists already, and I want to show the progress of this process within Visual Studio Code. Great, that looks like it worked. Next, I need to create a dataset object, which is a class of Azure ML Core. And I need to format my date in a way that'll make it easier for me to sort my data. So I need to import some classes. Now I need to figure out which column I'm going to use to predict which other column. Before I decide this, I'm going to open up the CSV file and take a look at the data that I have. I notice that in here, I've got date, season, year, month, which day of the week, what the weather is, the temperature, the humidity, the wind speed, and I also have count, which is the number of bikes that have been rented. I think what I'll do is I'll use date to predict count. So let's define that over here. Now I've got my time column name, which will be used to predict my target column name. Next, I'm going to create a local variable called dataset that'll keep track of my data, and I'm going to convert that dataset into a pandas data frame. Notice that I'm calling take5, which will print out the first 5 rows of this data frame. We can verify that these rows are correct. It's January 1st, 2011. The temperature was 0.344167. And we can take a look at our CSV file and see that it was still January 1st, 2011. And that the weather was, or the temp was 0.334467. So that's looking right. Now we have a link between our data stored in Azure and our local Visual Studio Code environment.